you can see, there's a bucket of firewood sitting right here. I just carried two like this into the house. I'll get this one on my way back. I want to show you what Selina's doing because I think it's brilliant. As most of you know, one of our primary sources of heat is wood. That sound is Selina chopping up the slabs that she's not going to use for building. They've been sitting there in the driveway on pallets for a year to 18 months. She used tie-down straps to hold the bundle slabs together, and she is cutting the lengths she needs. And as she finishes with a particular length and takes the strap off, she cuts away the underlying pallet and is using it for wood as well. I'll take you up closer to see it, but you won't be able to hear anything but the saw. Unless, of course, she's not sawing at that moment. She's going ahead and putting the wood she's cutting into the blacksmith shop because this winter, she'll just get the wood from this stack and carry it in, and it'll stay dry in there. So I'm going to turn off the camera and start carrying wood in there. Anyway, I wanted to show you because I think this is a brilliant hack, the way she has these tie-down straps ratcheted down, holding the wood in place. Might we talk about it?
Okay, so after I got done working in the treehouse, not that I think you fuckers are lazy or anything, I came out here to cut some wood because we're running low. This is some slabs. I had these slabs stored on this pallet. And it dawned on me that rather than bring my sawhorses over here when I already had this, that I could snake these through there, through the pallet. And I'll tell you how I did that, because rather ingenious. Tied to the pallet, and then just used the pallet as my sawhorse to cut it all up at once. It was really quick, it was really easy. The bottom boards, the boards that were touching the pallet aren't that good, but I'm gonna be able to get three boards.
Oh, wonderful.
Off this pallet. These were the little nasty ones.
Yes.
But there's some nice big ones on the bottom. I think I can scavenge.
Yay.
When I get done with this. But at any rate, pallets, dime a dozen. We talked about that already.
Yes.
I'm going to show you how I snaked it through because it was kind of genius. I was like, I need me something I can hook on to the hooks so I can get it through the hole in the pallet. So I went into my shop and I'm looking around. And I find this thing. It's some decorative hanging. It used to be a windmill or something.
Yes.
That somebody threw away and that I took. So I very simply just stuck it through the pallet.
Oh my.
Put the hook on it and then just pulled the hook through and then attached it.
I wondered how you did that. Everything else was clear to me, but how you got that through was not.
That's how I did it. With this, you don't have to have a shepherd's crook, magical wind chimes that somebody threw away.
Yeah.
You could just, and God only knows why I did that. Probably at one point I stuck it in the ground to tell somebody, don't run over this.
Who knows?
You know, I use shit all the time that other people just throw out. But at any rate, but you could just use a piece of wire.
Yeah.
If you had like a coat hanger, you could take the coat hanger, do the same thing.
Right.
Just leave the wire coat hanger, you dumb fucks, not plastic. How would that work? It's got to be stiff enough to go through the pallet. But there, yeah, that's how I did it.
That is so cool.
Yeah, so I cut what is basically the equivalent of, well, ricka wood.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, it's a ricka wood. So it's equivalent of ricka wood. I cut it in about 2 hours?
Yeah, it was 2 hours.
Probably an hour and a half.
It's been an hour and a half since I left the treehouse. And so probably about an hour. Mm-hmm.
That way, so.
That's pretty amazing.
Easy to do. Those are just ratchet straps.
Yeah, really cool. Totally awesome. And it's ready to...
I use ratchet straps when I use my sawhorses anyway, because I ratchet strap the wood together before I start cutting it, because otherwise that saw is so powerful. Thank you again, Gene.
Yes, yes.
That saw is so powerful, it'll sling the shit into you.
Yeah, so you have to be careful, yeah.
So,
that's awesome.
Yeah. Anyway. And that way I don't have to have anybody around when I'm doing it.
Yep.
To hold the boards. Screw all that. And now it's as easy as taking it apart.
That is so cool.
So, yeah.
Yay. Okay, I'm going to go away.